On arrival in Manaus, we don't even have time to acclimate to the incredibly high level of humidity, almost 100%. But we have to rush to buy hammocks for our trip and then head down to the port to get on the boat, which will take us up the rusty brown waters of the Rio Negro from 35 hours to the Xixuau Reserve.
Ci aspettano circa 35 ore di viaggio.
Mentre assicuriamo. While we set up our hammocks for the night, the sailors in the port load the boats with all kinds of merchandise destined for the outlying jungle communities.
Sparuti villaggi della foresta.
Forse senti una mollezza, senti due sani una, tem a vida atrapalhada, não consegue coisa alguma. Então ouça meu conselho. Pois não perca mais seu tempo e tome banho cheiroso.
The time for departure approaches and the upper decks get more and more crowded with hammocks and baggage, to the point where we have people lying down beside, above and below us. Before we realize it, fatigue takes over and we fall asleep before even casting off from land, not even remembering to keep a watchful eye on our luggage. Luckily, when we wake up, nothing is missing, and the sight that greets our eyes is absolutely breathtaking. It's dawn, and we're still sailing along the Rio Negro, one of the main tributaries of the Amazon River, which takes on the name of the Salamoes, upstream from Manaus. With a surface area of 1,580,000 square kilometers, the state of Amazonas occupies a huge area of the Amazon basin and is the largest state in Brazil. The lives of the local people are wholly dependent upon the rivers. Transportation, food, water, waste disposal, and of course tourism depend upon this mighty river system. Rivers are the roads of the Amazon, and the boats which plow its waters offer a unique glimpse of the local lifestyle. Time passes slowly on board, and to pass the time, some read. Others play cards or dominoes. The monotony of the landscape is only interrupted by the frequent storms, which are common during the rainy season, and by the meals, which mark the passing of time. The boat pulls into the small port of the town of Novo Airão, just long enough to unload everything necessary for the local inhabitants, and we have the opportunity to make the acquaintance of three pink dolphins. These magnificent animals show no fear of us, but instead come to us as if to welcome us. The journey continues, and it's already night when we finally spy the Certeza, the boat which belongs to the association and which will take us to the reserve, our final destination. The next morning, we meet Chris and his wife Anna, founders of the Reserve and the Amazon Association, which has been working with the local people on sustainable development projects in this remote part of Brazil for 15 years. After another 10 interminable hours of navigation, we finally reached the community of Xixuau.
Chris
Chris informs us that the ecological reserve was formed in 1992 and covers an area of 178,000 hectares, or nearly 44,000 acres of primary forest, in places unexplored. It is situated in the southernmost part of the state of Roraima, 400 kilometers to the northwest of Manaus and only 50 kilometers south of the equator. The project is clear proof of how it's possible to preserve the Amazon forest by improving the lives of the local people. From the very start, they have been working in two directions: environmental protection and the support of the local community, the Caboclos, which have a mixture of indigenous, African, and European blood. Lights have been installed in the houses thanks to a solar energy system, and in 2002, the first primary school was opened. Thanks to this, Pelado, who was born in Xixuau and moved to the city to study, has been able to realize his dream. He has come home to teach his brothers. Thanks to a modern satellite system, the village has multimedia technology, which allows adults and children to learn how to use the computer and to study beyond primary level without having to move to the city. Recently, even a public phone booth has been installed.
Eu sou assim, quem quiser gostar de mim sou assim. Eu sou assim, quem quiser gostar de mim sou assim. Meu mundo é hoje, não existe amanhã pra mim. E sou assim, assim morrerei um dia.
Francineide runs the health post, thanks to which it's been possible to keep the frequent epidemics of malaria under control, and she provides first aid services to the inhabitants of the community. All this helps avoid residents from having to abandon their roots and traditions, and allows them to make their voices heard beyond the confines of the forest. Tourists stay in Molocas, lodges of wood and straw built in the style of Waimiri Atroari Indians, and days are dedicated to long walks in the forest and excursions along the rivers where, with a bit of luck, it's possible to see a great variety of animals. Many species of monkeys, a beautiful toucan, and this beautiful brightly colored bird, the macaw. We are blessed by fortune, and to everybody's surprise, we see a jaguar. The next day is dedicated to an outing by canoe into the flooded forest, known here as the Igapó. During the rainy season from March to September, the waters can rise up to 12 meters, leaving only isolated patches of dry land. After several hours of navigating through the thick, flooded forest, thanks to the experience of our guides Grillo and Franchi, we come across a group of five giant otters among the rarest of their species.
Solidão é lava que cobre tudo, amargura em minha boca, sorri seus dentes de chumbo. Solidão, palavra cavada no coração, resignado e mudo no compasso da desilusão.
In the afternoon, after a nap to help digest the specialties prepared by Paella, the cook, Mambichi and Grillo take us out for fishing for piranha. Unlike the cinema myth, it is people who eat this aggressive but delicious fish here. Mambichi is truly a master fisherman, and he explains to us that, unlike other fish, the piranha are attracted to noise in the water. He pulls out one after another and moves around continuously in search of the largest ones. It's a lot of fun and another chance for a trip through the flooded forest.
Meu pai sempre me dizia, meu filho, tome cuidado. Quando eu penso no futuro, não esqueço meu passado. Desilusão, desilusão, danço eu, dança você, na dança da solidão. Desilusão, desilusão, danço eu, dança você, na dança da solidão. Quando chega a madrugada, meu pensamento vagueia. Corro os dedos na viola, contemplando a lua cheia. Apesar de tudo existe uma fonte de água pura. Quem beber daquela água não terá mais amargura.
Ogni giorno, prima di here, like elsewhere in Brazil, the late afternoon is dedicated to playing football. Here, even the women are extremely skilled at the game.
A cabocla tem riquezas no Amazonas, no Pará, em Roraima e no Acre e no estado do Amapá. Porém, seus filhos herdeiros não sabem aproveitar. Porém, seus filhos herdeiros não sabem aproveitar. O ouro do Tapajós, muito longe daqui está. O ferro que já surgiu, fugiu para outro lugar. E as lágrimas da Amazônia, onde...
It's even possible to go shopping. In fact, the women in the community make craftwork belts, necklaces, and bracelets from the abundant variety of colorful seeds in the forest.
Amazônia está chorando, caboclo tá, tá, tá. E a madeira viajando e fazendo morada pro lado de lá. A cabocla tem riquezas no Amazonas, no Pará, em Roraima e no Acre e no estado do Amapá.
With our rucksacks full of souvenirs, we leave. We leave the reserve with a hope in our hearts that the work done by Chris and the other members of the association can be an example and lead, in the not too distant future, to the realization of a dream, that all the inhabitants of the Amazon can have the same opportunities as those that live in Xixuau.
Amazônia está chorando, caboclo tá, tá, tá. E a madeira viajando e fazendo morada pro lado de lá. Amazônia está chorando, caboclo tá, tá, tá. E a madeira viajando e fazendo morada pro lado de lá.